Hi! So, welcome back po sa ating video tutorial. So, this afternoon or in this video, I will be discussing about one of the most important topic no, na tinuturo natin or dinidiscuss natin sa IMG. So, our topic for this tutorial or video tutorial and financial coaching is all about debt management. Okay, so in my 7 years of being part of the company, isa to sa mga topic na talagang binibigyan din natin because unfortunately, isa to sa mga financial struggle ng karamihan ng Pilipino. So expect that this video tutorial will be discussing so many techniques and realities kung bakit tayo nagkakautang and how we'll be able to manage that just in case na existing na yung mga utang natin and as of now, nagpa-pile up na. Okay, so as you all know, I'm Realyn Familiar and together with my husband Andrew, we do this tutorial videos para nang sa ganun we can reach out to more Filipinos outside UAE kung saan nandito kami ngayon, but we want to educate more Filipinos outside Middle East para nang sa ganun sabay-sabay tayo to increase our financial knowledge. We've been part of the company since September 2012 and continuously we're educating ourselves, applying the concept na natututunan namin sa IMG, and by doing so, sinishare namin kung ano man yung mga natututunan namin. So, with this financial coaching, expect to learn the following. So, unang-una, why people fall into heavy debt? Ano ba yung mga reason? Siyempre, kung bibigyan natin ng solusyon, gusto nating i-find out muna or i-figure out ano ba yung cause? Bakit maraming tao ang nagpo-fall into borrowing money? And then, second, ano yung dalawang two types of interest rates? So, very powerful, no? Kung naiintindihan natin ano may different types of interest rates, the moment na makita natin siya, naiintindihan na natin siya. And it will make a lot of difference in the future kapag natutunan natin itong dalawang klaseng interest rate na to, should we face such terminology. So, iba din yung effect kapag naiintindihan natin. And then, steps of getting out of the debt trap, di ba? From the word trap, talagang mahirap yan. Kumbaga, parang naakulong ka na sa utang. Pero may mga paraan para makalabas tayo dyan. And then, ways to avoid drowning and credit card debts. So, isa yan sa pinaka-common na cause ng utang, no? From credit cards kapag na hindi na-handle properly. And then, getting out of credit card debts. I-discuss din natin yan. So, as you all know, kung napanood na ninyo yung Secret to Saving and Building Your Future orientation natin, this was discussed in Chapter 4 of the book, Managing Debts Effectively. So, review lang tayo konti. But, mas didiinan natin in this training, more terminologies, more solutions about this problem, about mga utang, diba? So, balikan natin yung Chapter 4 ng SSBYF book. So, why should we manage our debts? Kapag hindi natin na-manage yung debt natin properly, debt will manage us. Baliktad yun. And kapag debt na ang may control ng buhay natin, medyo mahirap. So, debt can turn into a disease. Kumbaga, disease, hindi lang siya basta illness, di ba? Pag sinabing disease, it's an illness na pabalik-balik. Di ba? Mamaya, mas maintindihan natin bakit daw ang debt, pag nag-turn siya into a disease, bakit siya, ano ba yung reason kung bakit paulit-ulit tayo nagpo-fall into debt? So, it could control your life, diminish your happiness, and limit your freedom. Hindi ba napakalungkot nun kapag hindi ka full in control or utang ang nagko-control ng buhay natin? Sabi nga, i-diminish your happiness, nababawasan yung, syempre, pag wala kang masyadong freedom, di ba parang hirap maging masaya. And you can never be truly free until you are debt-free. So, itong mga few tips na ibibigay ko, diniscuss na natin to sa Secret to Saving and Building Your Future Orientation, pero dadagdagan natin siya today. But just a review, kasi maganda rin naman itong mga tips na shinare natin dun sa first video natin, so balikan natin na konti. So, control your debt or debt will control you. First, pay off your credit card debts in full and on time. Diba? We'll have a full discussion about that later on in this training. Second, so next would be consider liquidating your savings and non-income producing assets. Oh, sorry, balikan natin yung slide. Okay, so second strategy is don't get into more debt, live below your means. Diba, disiplina pa rin yan eh. Kapag existing na or meron na tayong mga existing na utang, focus, mag-focus muna tayo para mabawasan yun. Until such time, ma-zero out na yung utang natin. So don't get into more debts. And then, kapag nakalabas na tayo nun sa utang, syempre huwag na tayong bumalik, diba? And then, ito, use cash or debit cards. We will have a further discussion about that. Spend on necessities, not on luxuries. Every time you buy something, pag-isipan mo nang mabuti, kailangan ko ba to? Kailangan ko ba siyang bilhin? Or luho lang siya? Is it something na kapag binili ko, matatambak lang siya sa cabinet ko? Or matatagalan bago siya magamit? So, sayang yung pera, di ba? Number 5, make a list of all your debts and pay them off one at a time. Kung meron na existing na utang, huwag nating pakiramdaman yung utang natin. We have to be very specific. How many debts do we have? How much, rather? And then, we should have a deadline kung kailan natin siya gustong mabayaran. And then, increase your cash flow. We had a video tutorial how to increase your cash flow. So, pwede niyong balikan yun. Obviously, kapag na-increase natin yung cash flow natin, the faster that we can pay off our debt. Diba? So, ayan, isa yan sa una talaga natin kailangan gawin kapag meron tayong mga existing na utang. One of the things that we need to focus on is to increase our cash flow. So, there are two ways to increase your cash flow. Earn additional income during your spare time. And then, minimize your expenses. So, like what I mentioned, we have one full series of training for that. Balikan nyo na po yung video tutorial. We discuss their different strategies para ma-increase natin yung cash flow natin. And then number 7, consider liquidating your savings and non-income producing assets. So kung meron tayong mga existing na assets na stagnant siya, di ba? Pero meron din tayong mga debts na nagpa-pile up, especially dahil may interest rate, we suggest na why not consider liquidating yung savings mo and yung non-income producing assets natin para nang sa ganun, kung ano man yung maliquidate natin na amount, magamit natin para pambayad muna ng utang. And then, pag zero out na yung utang natin, we start accumulating again assets. At least, di ba, hindi nako-compensate ng interest ng utang natin, yung interest ng investments natin. And then, nako-compromise rather, not compensate, nako-compromise. And then number 8, change your money mindset. Debt is not a solution, but an obstruction. Di ba, we shared one strategy para nang sa ganun, every time you face an emergency, hindi utang ang una nating naiisip na solusyon because gaya ng sabi dito, it's not a solution. Regardless kung yun ang kinalakihan natin, yun ang naituro sa atin, we are trying to correct that mindset na kapag may utang or if we have a financial struggle, borrowing money is not actually a solution. It's something that will give you more emergency and will give you more problem. Prepay your mortgage. Kung meron tayong mga existing na mortgages, the faster that we can pay it off, mas napapababa natin yung interest ng utang natin or ng mortgage natin. Okay, so following the script of life, tingnan natin to, no? If you track the life of average educated people, the principal, the financial script often goes like this. So tingnan natin, this is the story of your life or kung bagong graduate ka, is maganda, as early as now, malaman natin itong script of life nito para medyo maiwasan natin. Malaman natin yung strategy para hindi ito yung mangyari sa atin. Or do you know someone na ganito yung naging story ng life nila, kaya ngayon medyo financially struggling sila. Tingnan natin if it's true. But when I've read this, I totally agree and I'm grateful na una kong na-attendan itong training na to, I was only 26. So, gaya ng sabi ko, na-avoid ko siya immediately kasi nga, napahinggan ko na siya ng maaga. Okay, so it begins, di ba? A child goes to school, graduates, finds a job, and soon has some money to spend. Di ba, very common yan sa mga Pilipino. Talagang pinaglalaban natin to finish ang education natin because it's very important. And if you'd ask a person bakit gusto niya makagraduate so that makahanap ng magandang trabaho, magkaroon ng magandang income. So yun yung common nating nagiging goal habang nag-aaral tayo. So, the young adult can now afford to rent an apartment or maybe start, you know, humiwalay na sa parents kasi yung tatrabaho na, find his or her own place. So, nagre-rent na, buy branded clothes and a car, lalo na kung medyo hindi naman maginhawa yung buhay no nung nag-aaral pa. No, finally, if you're already earning money, parang yung mga gusto mo or mga hindi mo nabibili nung nag-aaral ka pa, finally, meron ka ng capacity to buy, like branded clothes. Diba? And now the bills begin to come in. But there is no problem kasi meron ka namang trabaho. What happens next? So one day, the adult meets someone special, sparks fly, they fall in love and get married. Diba? So for a while, life is blissful because two can live cheaply as one. Kasi nung hindi ka pa kasal, you're paying for the rent na ikaw lang. But now, all of a sudden, both of you can stay, that after marriage, you can stay in one roof. So, ang rent ninyong dalawa is isa na lang. Pero, pareho pa kayong kumikita ng pera. So, parang nabuwasan yung expenses. So, they now have two incomes, only one rent to pay. Okay? Kaya lang, ano yung nagiging change and nagiging mindset kapag ganito na yung sitwasyon? So, they can afford to set a few pesos aside to buy the dream of all young couples. Ano ba yan? Lahat naman ang pangarap ng young couples is to have their own home. Diba? So, medyo nakaluwag ng konti sa rent. So, feeling ninyong dalawa, you have enough money to start or parang bumili na ng sarili ninyong bahay. Okay. So, they find their dream house or dream home, pull the money from the savings kung meron mang existing na na ipon. So, you pull out that savings to pay for the deposit or the down payment. And then, pwede na kayo lumipat dun sa bahay nyo. And then, monthly, you just have to pay kung magkano man yung yung bill or yung kailangan bayaran for that house na hinuhulugan ninyo. So, because they have a new house, anong kailangan gawin? Bago yung bahay. So, dapat bumili ka ng bagong appliances, bumili ka ng bagong furniture. So, they need new furnishing. So, they find a furniture store that advise them those magic words. Ano yung magic words na yun? Ito yun. No money down, easy installment payments. Diba? No money down, easy installment payments. So, kung meron kayo existing na credit card, or pwede rin may mga appliance loans din, you apply. So, what happens next? Siyempre, maganda yung bagong bahay natin. So, ano mangyayari? You throw a party. Diba? Anong tinatawag doon? Housewarming party. To have all their friends, even their relatives, over to see their new house. And then their new car, and then their new furniture. Kaya lang, kung titignan natin yung picture, dahil lahat yan ay naka-loan, they are now deeply in debt for the rest of their lives. Diba? Yung bahay, ilang taon mo ba yun babayaran? Yung kotse na kinuha natin, or yung kinarloan natin, ilang taon mo ba yung babayaran? And then the appliances na in-apply natin through appliance loan, or binili natin through credit card, gano'ng katagal natin yung mahuhulugan. So, kung isusuma total mo yon in total, almost half or the rest of your life, you're already indebted. So, may kilala ba kayong ganyan? Or is that, nakarelate ba kayo? Ganyan ba yung nangyari sa inyo? So, yun yung susolusyon na natin ngayon. Kung hindi pa, it's a very good thing that you are able to attend this training or watch this video like me, na you can avoid this scenario. Ito na yung next. So then, the first job arrives. Diba? You have your housing loan, you have your car loan, you have your appliance loan. So you're paying off for all these debts and then suddenly, the first job arrives. May expenses ba? That's a very good news, no? Pero when you're already indebted, parang medyo mahirap i-balance yung expenses. So the average well-educated, hard-working couple, after dropping the child off the nursery, anong kailangan nilang gawin? Kailangan nilang pumasok sa trabaho. Wala silang choice. Diba? Kasi meron silang marami silang binabayaran. So, they become trapped by the need for job security simply because, on average, they are less than 3 months away from financial bankruptcy. Diba? Ibig sabihin, in 3 months' time, kung bigla silang mawala ng trabaho, bankrupt na. Kasi nga, binabayaran nila yung bahay, binabayaran nila yung kotse, binabayaran nila appliances. Plus now, they have a kid na syempre kailangan mapakainin, may mga expenses din niya. So, this couple can no longer afford to lose their job. Okay, so from these people, you often hear, I cannot afford to quit. I have bills to pay. Diba? Hirap na sa trabaho, kahit anong ipagawa ng amo nila or ng employer nila, kahit nag-overtime na, wala na halos oras para sa pamilya, wala na halos pamilya, wala na halos time para magpahinga. They cannot afford to quit. They cannot afford to lose their job kasi nga maraming kailangan bayaran. Or a modification from a song from Snow White and Seven Dwarfs. Ano yan? Modification lang to. Para hindi naman masyadong nakakatakot or nakakalungkot yung discussion natin. Kasi I owe, so it's off to work I go. May utang ako, so wala akong choice, kailangan kong pumasok. Even during times na may sakit ka, even during days na tinatamad ka, maybe pumasok. We don't have a choice, we have to go to work kasi we have debts na kailangan nating bayaran. So debt can be beneficial if you're responsible in handling. There are a lot of entrepreneurs who are using debt to para palakihin yung business nila, but gaya nga nasabi dito, it can be beneficial kung responsable tayo sa pag-handle ng debt na yun. But if not, kung hindi natin ma-handle properly, debt can be your worst nightmare. Studies after studies show that wealthy people avoid debt, or if they use debt, they use it wisely. So there's a big difference between bad debt and good debt, and kung matututunan natin how to use it, pwede natin siyang magamit into our advantage. But, gaya nga nasabi dito, wealthy people, as much as possible, they avoid borrowing money. And even if they do so, ginagamit nila in their advantage to expand probably or most likely their business. Okay, so it is a rule of financial and economic life that interest is to be paid on borrowed money. Karamihan ng utang ay may interest. So that's part of loan. So once in debt, interest is your companion every minute of day and night. So for as long as hindi pa natin nababayaran in full yung utang natin, merong kaakibat na interest yan. So maganda na intindihan din natin dapat yung interest. So according to Ruben Clark, you cannot shun it or slip away from it. You cannot dismiss it. It yields neither to entities, demands, or orders. And whenever you get it in its way or cross its course or fail to meet its demand, it crushes you. So if you fail to pay off our debt, tapos may interest pa yan, talagang napakalaki ng epekto niyan sa ating financial life. So a typical debt and credit card purchase can cost up to 100% more than if cash were used. Diba? So kung it simply shows na gusto lang namang statement na iparating dito is if you can pay off whatever purchases that you have, if you can pay it via cash, much better pa rin. Diba? It's always much better. So these are some questions. Why financial crisis is everywhere? Do you have an answer to that? Second question, what is the US problem? Ano problema ng US? Di ba maraming, you know, you will see a lot of people talking about this kapag nanood ng news, they're very much, very attentive kapag yun yung topic. Or, what is the Europe problem? May problema ba sa Europe, sa economy ng Europe? But, para sa akin, no? And we also want you to realize that the most important problem that we need to focus on is what is your problem in terms of your finances? Why? Because you cannot control our country's economy. Although we can contribute for its betterment. Second, you cannot control our world's economy. Hindi yan fully in our control. You cannot control your company's economy. Diba? Wala rin yan sa kamay natin. And you cannot control your friend's economy. But this is something na for some reason we are in control of, pero for some reason ayaw nating pagtuunan ng pansin. This is the good news. You can control your own economy. So, kung among all of this, ang may control ka is yung sarili mong ekonomiya, so might as well give all your energy and your focus to learn about this and pagandahin yung personal economy natin. Okay, financial stress leads to, is this true? Na kapag financially stressed ka, you're also emotional stressed, you are also physically stressed, it follows, di ba? Minsan kapag may problema ka sa pera, it affects your emotions, parang mas sensitive ka. Kapag financially stressed ka, it affects your physical health, masakit ulo mo, di ba? So, physical stress yan. Even mental stress, kasi kakaisip. And then job stress. You know, according to statistics, if you have financial problem, medyo hindi ka ganun ka-effective sa trabaho mo as to compare it para dun sa mga tao na financially secured. Diba? Parang mas relax sila magtrabaho, hence they are more effective kung ano man yung work nila. So don't let a mountain of debt turn your sweet life sour. Ayaw natin yan. But kung pag-aralan natin mabuti, this is the sad truth. Marami pong tao ang lubog sa utang, kaya that's why talagang they are affected in terms of their emotion, in terms of their in terms of their health, in terms of their mental health, and even yung trabaho nila affected. So let's answer this very important question. Why people fall into heavy debt? Wala namang sigurong tao na pinangarap nilang malubog sa utang. Pero despite of that, bakit maraming nalulubog sa utang? So importante malaman natin yan. So first is they spend more than what they earn. For some reason, we feel job security. Kahit sa anggulo naman nating tingnan, hindi naman talaga tayo secure kung ano man yung trabaho natin ngayon. Anytime, our company can kick us out. So for some reason, some people, they spend more than they earn, thinking na okay, kaya ko naman bayaran kasi may trabaho naman ako. So they live beyond their means. Second reason is no emergency fund. So very important yan, no? If you have an emergency fund, whatever happens, meron kang paghuhugutan. Diba? So even responsible people and wise spenders are caught in debt trap when emergency strikes and they have no emergency fund. Sabihin natin na disiplinado ka naman, na pagkakasya mo naman yung sahod mo. Hindi ka naman nag-fall dun sa first reason na you spend more than what you earn. Kaya lang wala kang emergency fund. When emergency happens, ganun pa rin ang option mo, manghihiram ka pa rin ng pera. Diba? Kasi hindi mo naman pwedeng talikuran din ng emergency. Paano kung meron, let's say there's a typhoon, or there's a tragedy, or someone in the family gets sick. Diba? So that's all part of emergency. Or bigla ka mawala ng trabaho, that's part of emergency. So wala kang utang, or kasya-kasya yung sahod mo, sakto-sakto siya, kaya lang bigla ka nagkaroon ng emergency, ang ending mo pa rin, manihiram ka pa rin ng pera. So next, instant gratification. Marami yan. So cannot delay gratification, instant achievement of goal. Gaya ng sample na pinakita ko kanina, di ba? Instant gratification, hindi pa naman afford nung newlywed na bumili na ng bahay, but since gusto na nilang makuha yung dream house nila, they cannot delay that gratification, so they fall for a house loan. Diba? Without the security or assurance na kaya nilang bayaran yung loan na yun in full. Number four, in search of recognition and fame. Hindi ba ang sarap pag na-recognize if you have this branded watch, this branded shoes, this branded bag, diba? Pero yung recognition na yun, gaano ba siya katagal, tumatagal? Ilang minuto, ilang araw, and then wala na. Diba? So in search for recognition and fame, people try to impress people by buying expensive car, gadgets, go to parties every time, and then post it on social media. They try to meet these needs through heavy borrowings. Diba? Branded yung lahat ng suot. Pero utang naman lahat. Or laging nakabakasyon, pero lahat naman yun ay naka-credit card. Number five is wrong belief. Yung paniniwala, yung kinalakihan nating paniniwala na ang utang ay solusyon sa lahat ng problema, hindi po yan totoo. Diba? Debt is the only solution. Hindi rin po yan totoo. Like what we've mentioned, we can prepare ahead of time by creating an emergency fund. And then lastly, credit card is a source of additional income. There was a point before I became part of IMG, also because of lack of financial knowledge, diba, mababa pa yung financial intelligence natin at the time. I thought na when a credit card was offered to me, it's an extension to my income. Kasi nga hindi mo naiintindihan eh. But come to think of it, hindi siya additional income. Whenever you use the credit card, you have to pay for it. Na magagaling pa rin dun sa existing na income mo. So it's not an additional income. Okay? No discipline. Yan naman talaga ang main issue, di ba? Kung bakit we fall into debt. So you may know what to do to prevent falling into heavy debt, but can you solve the discipline issue and put it into action? Minsan, alam naman natin kung ano yung kailangan nating gawin, kailangan nating iwasan para hindi tayo malubog sa utang. Pero because walang disiplina, hindi natin sinusunod or hindi natin ina-apply. Diba? So people may know that smoking is not good for their health, pero bakit hindi sila makapaghinto sa paninigarilyo? Diba? Lack discipline. Gusto mong pumayat, pero alam mo that the way for you to lose weight is to exercise and then avoid yung mga hindi tamang pagkain. So, alam natin kung ano yung solusyon, alam natin kung ano yung dapat gawin, but due to lack of discipline, hindi natin ginagawa. Diba? So, almost similar din yan kung bakit many people fall into everything. So, the level of your success will depend on the amount of discipline you have. So, if you want to become successful in getting out of debt, if you want to become successful in managing your debts, so, isa sa kailangan talaga nating i-acquire is discipline. So, without discipline, people can stop debt and spending. And saving is a habit, so is debt and spending. Diba? Gusto kong ulitin yung part na yon. Ang pag-iipon daw ay isang habit. Pero ang pag-utang ng pera is habit din. So, with enough discipline, we can break that habit of borrowing money and then turn it into a habit of saving money. So, people in debt forever because of a habit. Yun yung kinalakihan, yun yung nakita nung bata pa siya. So, yun din yung solusyon na in-apply niya nung pagtanda niya. But because of IMG, we are breaking that habit. Pinapaalam natin sa tao na that is not the right solution. Hindi yun yung tamang gawin. So, that's why there's a very good chance that we can break that habit. So, kung na-break mo yung habit na yun sa sarili mo, that's something that you can pass on to your kids. Diba, the habit of saving. If I were to ask you, kung meron kang gustong ituro sa future kids mo, is it a habit of spending or is it a habit of borrowing money? Siyempre, doon tayo sa habit of saving and investing, right? So, para magawa natin yun, una, kailangan natin i-develop muna sa sarili natin. So, another secret destroyer kung bakit a lot of people fall into heavy debt, that is high interest debt and other charges. Marami kasi hindi naiintindihan yan, kaya they borrow money without understanding yung high interest and other charges. And they would say it's hidden charges, but it's not hidden charges. Lahat po yan is in print. Kaya lang, most of the time, honestly, hindi natin binabasa, kaya hindi natin naiintindihan. So, I'll be showing to you some debt charges na we should be aware of. So, kung meron mang utang or if you'll be signing something, this is something that you need to pay attention to. So, let's say for example, for credit cards and personal loans, hindi nagre-require ng collateral. Pero, the creditor require higher interest rate. Siyempre, hindi ka hiningan ng collateral, di ba? So, ang tendency is mas mataas yung interest ng credit card expenditures and personal loans. So, to compensate yung risk ng utang natin. So, most of them, not all, but most credit cards have 22 days as grace period. So, walang interest kung mababayaran natin in full within that, on or before the due date or within 22 days of grace period. Versus credit card loans and personal loans, ang housing loan and auto loans, nagre-require sila ng collateral. And because of that, mas mababa yung interest rate nila sa credit card and personal loan. So, since it is more secured debt, housing loan and car loan have lower fees and interest rates. So, other than interest rate, lending companies charge also other fees. May iba-iba pang charges yan. Like appraisal fees, insurance, transaction fees, annual fees, late charges, so on and so forth. So, mas maganda if you're applying, but I hope you will not be needing to apply for any loan. But just in case, these are the things that you need to ask. Meron ba iba pang mga charges that I need to understand para alam ko kung na hindi lang itong amount na niloan ko ang kailangan kong bayaran. So maganda or importante na naiintindihan natin yon. Okay, compounding interest is working against you. Diba in our in many video tutorials we discuss about compounding interest, the rule of 72. In our secret to saving and building your future orientation, we discuss about rule of 72. With this formula, pinapakita natin how many years it will take for your money to double. But also, we can use rule of 72 para makita natin gaano kabilis bago dumoble yung perang inutang mo. Kasi may interest rate din ang utang, di ba? So anything that has interest rate, pwede natin magamit yung rule of 72 to calculate bago, ilang taon bago dumoble or gaano kabilis bago dumoble yung perang in-invest mo or inutang natin. Okay. So, kung mataas ang interest rate, ito yung isa sa mga problema kasi yung compounding interest ay hindi siya nagtatrabaho para matulungan tayo to build a solid financial foundation, rather, it's working against you. I'll show you an example. Okay, at 4% interest rate, so using the rule of 72, 72 divided by the interest rate, so 72 divided by 4 is 18. Meaning, at the age of 29, if you have 100,000 of investment at 4%, pagdating mo ng age 65, that becomes 400,000. What if you have an investment of 100,000 earning 4% annually, pero meron kang utang na 100,000 na ang interest rate niya is 12% annual. So, since mas mataas yung interest rate, gamitin natin yung formula, 72 divided by the interest rate, which is 12, so 72 divided by 12 is 6. Mas mabilis dumoble yung amount ng utang, di ba? Kasi yung ang ginawa kong sample dito is yung 4% is your investment. But yung 12% is the interest rate to your debt. So, ibig sabihin, mas mabilis yung mas mabilis lumaki or dumoble yung amount ng utang natin compared dun sa amount ng investment natin. Kasi mas mataas yung interest rate ng utang natin compared dun sa interest rate ng ating investment. So, this is definitely compounding interest working against you. So, you save at 4%, pero yung utang mo is at 12%. This is also the reason why, kung babalikan natin yung solid financial foundation, mas nauna yung step no eliminating debt before investment. Because we don't want na yung interest ng utang natin ay kainin lang ng rather, yung interest ng investment natin ay kainin lang ng interest ng utang natin. Diba? So, this is a very good example. I hope you keep this in mind. If you will keep this in mind and apply natin sa financial strategy natin, talagang mas mabilis tayong makapag-build ng solid financial foundation. Number 9, losing value of money due to inflation. Diba? So, you save only at 1%, pero ang inflation rate ay 7%. So, ibig sabihin, the value of your money is losing 6% per year. So, 72 divided by 6, 6% yung binababa ng value ng pera natin, right? And so, 72 divided by 6 is 12. So, every 12 years, bumababa yung value ng pera. Tingnan natin yung illustration. So, the value of your money is reduced by half every 12 years. So, kung at age 29, meron kang 100,000, nag-invest ka pero sa 1% lang, so at the age of 41, yung 100,000 mo, 50,000 na lang ang value niya. At age 53, 25,000 na lang ang value. At age of 65, yung 100,000 mo, hindi na 100,000 yung value. 100,000 pa rin siya physically, pero ang value niya o yung purchasing power niya is 12,500 na lang. So, two types of interest rates. So, lack of understanding. There are two types of interest rate. The first one is add-on or nominal rate. Ang add-on or nominal rate is an interest rate based on the original loan amount and you pay the same amount of interest every month despite having paid up part of principal. So, ibig sabihin, if you borrow money and then napagkasunduan ninyo na ito yung amount na babayaran natin as interest dun sa utang natin. So, kahit pa nagbabawas ka na dun sa principal amount mo, fixed pa rin yung interest amount na kailangan mong bayaran. From the beginning to the end. Okay? Second type is diminishing or effective rate. Ang diminishing or effective rate is interest rate computed against diminishing balance. So, halimbawa, I'll be showing you an example, but I'll explain to you very briefly. Ang diminishing or effective rate naman is ganito. If you, from the capital, every time na nagbabayad ka ng utang mo, so nababawasan yung principal amount, right? Naka-base siya kung magkano na lang existing na principal amount. So, habang lumiliit yung principal amount, lumiliit din yung ating interest rate. So, those are two interest rate dapat na naiintindihan natin at least because it will make a very big difference sa financial life natin if we understand these two type of interests sa mga utang. So, pakita natin yung two examples in figures. Say, for example, we have a loan of 122,000 at interest rate of 2% per month on add-on. Diba? So, ibig sabihin fixed, payable in 12 months. So, ang monthly payment, yung principal is 112,000 divided by 12 kasi payable in 12 months siya, diba? So, ang kailangan mong bayaran every month is 10,000. Okay? So, on the first month, 120,000 pa siya, diba? Kasi first month pa lang. So, ang principal payment mo is 10,000. Monthly ang payment interest add-on is 2,400. Pero dun sa diminishing interest rate, same amount pa rin. Tingnan natin mo na second month. On the second month, ang amount loan balance mo na lang is 110,000. Okay, ito. 110,000. So, ang monthly principal, kasi payable siya in 12 months, di ba? So, ang monthly payment principal mo is again 10,000. So, fixed yan for the next 12 months. Sa monthly payment interest, kung add-on yung interest mo, fixed pa rin siya na 2,400. Kahit pa, on the second month, hindi na 120,000 yung utang mo. 110,000 na lang, right? Pero since add-on yung type ng interest rate mo, fixed na 2,400 yung kailangan mong bayaran. Pero tignan natin dun sa monthly payment interest, dun sa diminishing. So, on the second month, dahil 110,000 na lang yung principal amount ng utang natin, ang monthly payment interest monthly payment interest natin is hindi na 2,400, it becomes 2,200 na. So on and so forth. On the third month becomes 2,000, on the fourth month becomes 1,800, 1,600, 1,400, 1,200, 1,800, 600, 400, 200. Whereas dito sa monthly payment interest, kung add-on ang interest rate natin, fixed siya na 2,400 for the next 12 months. Ah, diba? Madali na naman siyang intindihin. Pero importante na naiintindihan natin ito. Diba? So, kung titignan natin, dun sa, para dun sa kung add-on, hindi siya talaga tumataas yung interest rate niya monthly. So, on the 12 month, it's even 24%. So, ang effective rate niya at the end of the 12 month, dun sa add-on is 74.48. Pero dun sa diminishing is only 24%. So you lost more money if the interest is deducted in advance. So halimbawa, you have a personal loan. Ito yung interest rate ng personal loan. So 5 to 10% per month is equivalent to 60 to 120% per year. Grabe yan. Can you imagine? So be very careful, no, because marami tayong naririnig na napakababa lang ng interest rate. It's only 5%. Pero hindi nila binibigyan ng attention yung term na 5%, yes, pero monthly. So, kung titignan natin on an annual basis, that's already 60% interest rate per year. Wow, napakalaki niyan. Ito, 20% per month, o yung tinatawag natin 5-6. In a year, that's 240% interest rate. So, 1% per day is 365% per year. So that, we have to be very careful. When someone tells you this, the interest rate of the loan, you ask, is it monthly or is it annual? Diba? Kasi most of the time, yun talaga yung hindi masyadong nabibigyan ng attention or kina-clarify. Rat race. So kapag ang tao is indebted, most likely ganito yung cycle ng buhay niya. No? So pile up yung trabaho, and then at the end of the month, kung once a month ang salary, like here in UAE, you receive your paycheck. Kung like in the Philippines, twice a month, quincenas katapusan. So, receive your income. After that, you pay off your bills. And then, lifestyle, walang disiplina. Shopping pa rin dahil medyo indebted na. Or living beyond their means. So, some of those expenses from the lifestyle ay kinukuha from loans. So, they fail to do budget. So, inuutang, kini-credit card. So, ang anong tendency? Walang ipon, and then balik ulit sa trabaho. Paulit-ulit lang yan. Trabaho, once you receive your paycheck, you pay off your bills, walang disiplina, you maintain yung very luxurious na lifestyle. So, kulang yung sahod mo para sa lifestyle mo, i-credit card mo, balik ulit sa pagtatrabaho. So, dekada na yung lumipas, 40 years old ka na, 50 years old ka na, you didn't acquire any financial, you didn't do anything para patasin yung financial knowledge natin, hindi tayo nag-acquire ng discipline. So 30, 40 years ka na nag-work, hindi ka pa rin nakapag-prepare for your retirement. Mas lumaki pa yung loans and mas indebted pa as to compare nung nag-start magtrabaho. So ito talaga yung tinatawag na rat cycle. And to be honest, nakakapagod po yan. Diba? Can you imagine yourself working every day pero wala kang nakikita ang kinapupuntahan nung pinagpapagurad mo? After 30, 40 years of working, 50 years of working, you didn't prepare anything for your retirement. So we need to break this cycle. And this is the reason why mas binibigay namin ang lahat ng oras namin and everything that we can do to conduct trainings like this and to record videos like this so that more and more Filipinos can get out of this rat race cycle. Okay, so steps to getting out of the debt trap. First, it all starts with a decision. So make a decision, make a plan, and then commit. Once you decide into something, syempre hindi naman yan matatapos or magagawa natin yung decision natin overnight. Hindi siya mag-take effect. So hanggat hindi pa natin na-achieve yung plano natin, so commit to that decision. So reducing debt is simple but it's not easy. Pero it's very doable. You just have to make that decision to get out of debt. You need to have a concrete plan paano natin yun magagawa and then you commit to that plan until such time talagang ma-achieve na natin. And then make a match and create a budget. You cannot manage your money if you don't know where your money is going. Match your debt payments versus your income. You have to be realistic about that to determine the sustainability of your loan payments. Number three, live below your means. As much as possible, simple lifestyle. Keep that simple lifestyle. I think even if you're indebted or not, if you're still starting to build your wealth, delay gratification muna, di ba? Keep a simple lifestyle. Kapag na-build mo na yung empire mo, na-build mo na yung wealth mo, darating din naman yung time. Pwede mo nang i-enjoy whatever is yung naipon natin and na-save natin. You can enjoy life. And if you start early, you can enjoy at a young age. Diba? So it's very difficult, I know, especially kapag hindi ka naman sanay to live a simple life or that's not something na nakagawian. Diba? Sabi nga habit. But if you're indebted, to be honest, you have no better option. Diba? So this is something na kailangan talaga nating i-apply. So pay off high interest debt first. So this is one of the strategy that we are teaching. So pakita ko sa inyo kung bakit. So kailangan daw nating targetin ano ba dun sa mga utang natin ang mas mataas ang interest rate. Kasi tingnan natin, very simple lang naman siya, diba? Kung ang utang mo is 100,000, ang interest rate niya per month is 10%, so that's 10,000 per month. As to compare it to a loan that 100,000 that has 1% interest rate per month, so ibig sabihin, ang interest rate lang niya is 1,000 per month. And then number 5, consolidate debt and credit swap. Titingnan pa natin yan later on in this training. Napagandang strategy na. So transfer a high interest debt to a lower interest debt. There are many lower interest debts alternatives. So debt consolidation and elimination strategy. So stop bringing big cash kung gusto natin makaiwas sa utang. This one very good strategy. No? Bakit? You go to an ATM machine to take out 5,000. Are you surprised at how little cash left a day after? Diba sabi nga, money without a plan is money soon gone. Kung medyo may lamang cash yung wallet natin, diba it's very easy to pull out cash and then yung mga bagay na hindi naman natin pinagpaplanuhang bilhin ay nabibili natin. Okay? Number 7, earn additional income. Diba sabi nga kanina, increase cash flow. And one best way to increase cash flow is to earn additional income. So change the habit of borrowing to habit of increasing your cash flow. Sabi nga, if you are going to, diba sabi natin, take out the habit of borrowing money. But if you're going to, one very effective way to take out the habit is to replace it of another habit. So kung tatanggalin natin yung habit of borrowing, i-replace natin yun with the habit of increasing your cash flow. So, ibig sabihin, halimbawa, balikan ko yung number 7. Halimbawa, habit of borrowing, nagsha-shopping ka using your credit card, di ba? Habit of borrowing yun. Kasi, you go out, but some habit, you use your credit card, so you're borrowing money by doing so. One way para ma-change mo yung habit na yun is why not exchange that activity into something that will give you start a business, diba? Something that will increase your cash flow or will give additional income to you. So that's, para sa akin, that's the explanation of number 7. Then number 8, try an option to liquidate savings and non-income producing assets. Yung sinabi rin natin kanina early dun sa introduction nitong training na to. So withdraw your savings to pay your high interest debt is a very good investment. Number 9, don't be ashamed to ask guidance. Kung feeling mo hindi mo na siya kayang solusyonan on your own, kailangan mo ng mentoring, kailangan mo ng someone that will guide you. And by doing so, this video, we are in the hope, we do this in the hope na should you need guidance in paying off your debt, ay makatulong yung video na to. So we have a lot of mentors and trainers in IMG na pwede mong i-approach, no? Baka may mabigay sa iyo na guidance or advice para ma-pay off yung debt. You can undergo financial checkup, you know, this is strategy. So find the most practical approach to resolve your situation, seek guidance from IMG mentors. So unpaid credit card balances are horrifying. So huwag natin yung pinapabayaan. The compounding interest works against you. Gaya sabi kanina, di ba, kapag credit card loans, napaka-taas po ng interest. So kung hindi natin siya binabayaran on time and in full, that is definitely compounding interest working against you. So you get buried more and more in debt. So ways to avoid drowning in credit card debt. So know the credit card terms and conditions. Meron po yan. Kahit pa hindi mo naman in-apply, maraming ganyan, di ba? Hindi mo naman in-apply yung loan na yun, yung credit card na yun, pero especially kung medyo malaki yung salary mo, all of a sudden, meron na lang dadating sa office or sa bahay mo na credit card and you just have to activate it. Kahit pa hindi mo siya in-apply, there are papers in the envelope. So, importante, should you decide to activate it, importante basahin natin yun para naintindihan natin what are the credit card terms and conditions. And then, manage well your income. Gaya nga nang sabi ako in earlier training, should you be able or should you decide to use your credit card? One very good strategy is that dapat meron kang equivalent amount na dun sa expenditure mo. Yung sigurado kang gamitin mo man tong credit card na to, meron ka ng equivalent about amount in your savings na pambayad dun sa expense na yun. And then reduce spending, di ba? It's very common, pero karami nag-fail. Kung di mo naman kailangan gamitin yung credit card mo, hindi mo naman kailangan bilhin yung isang bagay, so don't buy, di ba? At that's a necessary expense. So never consider shopping as a form of relief when you are depressed. So may mga ganyan, di ba? Kapag medyo depressed or medyo pagod sa trabaho, ang pampamper nila is shopping. Bibili ng sapatos, bibili ng bag, bibili na or kakain sa mamahaling restaurant. But come to think of it, diba, i-analyze natin, medyo i-analyze natin. Stress ka sa trabaho, so what you do, you buy expensive things through your credit card. So paano mo babayaran yung mga loans na yun or yung credit card na yun? You need to maintain your job. You need to maintain that work that is giving you stress. So cycle lang siya, diba? So you need to do something else. Something else that will get you out of that work that is giving you stress. Right? Number 4, avoid penalties. So be aware of the due dates. Pay in full, transactor rather than a revolver. Ano ba yan? A transactor is someone na yes, they use credit card, pero kung kailan yung due at magkano yung amount, they pay in full. A revolver is someone na they use credit card, hindi nila binabayaran in full, kini-carry over nila yung remaining amount on the following month, mas lalo pong tumataas yung interest rate. And then make sure that your payments arrive on time. Another thing is you have to update your personal information sa banko para notify your credit card company if you transfer residence or change of mobile phone to make sure your billing statements gets to you. Siyempre, very obvious, kapag hindi mo na-receive yung billing statement mo, so hindi mo alam kung meron ka pang remaining balance na kailangan mong bayaran, di ba? So, if that's the case, if you fail paying an amount that is in your credit card at inabot na ng taon yan, magugulat ka na lang talagang napakalaki na nung kailangan mo yan. And then number 6, keep personal information. No? Don't give out our credit card information and don't let your credit card to anyone. It is something na, you know, in my many years in IMG, napakarami na namin financial check-up that na nagawa. And I've seen a lot of people drowning in credit card debts, and some of them ay hindi naman sila yung gumamit ng credit card na yun. May nakikahit na kaibigan or ka-opisina, and then all of a sudden, hindi na binayaran. So sila yung nasushoulder nung utang na hindi naman sila yung gumamit. So you have to be very, very diligent about that and be very careful. So debit card versus credit card. Kami po personally, we prefer using debit cards, especially nowadays, even online transactions, pwede naman nang gamitin yung debit card. So, pero nasa inyo pa rin po yun, na-share ko lang na kung kami po, we prefer paying through debit card. So, ang debit card kasi, your spending capacity is limited to the amount cash you have in your debit card, di ba? Beyond that, hindi mo na magamit yung debit card mo. Pero ang credit card, may psychological effect yan. Kasi you have a credit limit that allows you to buy more than what you can afford. Halimbawa, ang credit limit mo is 20,000. What you have in your bank is only 10,000. You can buy something na worth 20,000 kahit ang pera mo lang may 10,000. Diba? So definitely, yung 10,000 pwede pang bayad pero may utang ka 10,000. So if you think you have difficulty in using credit card responsibly, then use only cash. Kung ayaw mo naman magdala ng cash, maraming ganyan like us, so use debit card. Diba? So getting out of credit card debt, first don't acquire additional debt. Diba? Kung may mga existing na credit card na utang, focus mo na tayo na matapos yun. So don't add debt while you're trying to pay them off. And then use fewer cards. Why? Because it's easier to collect credit points. And also, it is easier to maintain. Diba? Lalo na kung magkakaiba yan ang due date, kung lima-lima yan or sampu-sampu yan, ang hirap tandaan lahat. So, kung isa or dalawa lang, you know that your kailan yung due dates mo, madaling tandaan. So, mas mabilis nating mamanage. And then, pay more than minimum if you cannot pay in full. Siyempre, suggested, pay in full every time you can. But in the event na hindi mo kayang bayaran yung full amount, pay more than the minimum. Diba? Simple lang naman yan. Siyempre, kung magkano yung natitirang amount payable, yun yung magiging basis ng interest ng utang natin, di ba? So, decided deadline to pay off your debt. So, halimbawa, you have this existing loans, housing loan, car loan, salary loan, appliance loan, bank loan, so on and so forth. List down sa ang company yun, magkano yung amount, ilan yung interest rate, and how much you need to pay monthly. So, total up your debt, you total up your income, and then put a deadline, kailan mo siya gustong matapos or kailan mo siya gustong target na mabayaran in full. Importante po yan. Diba sabi kanina, diba, make a list of all your existing debts. Ayan, dito tayo sa debt roll-up. So, monthly debt payment. Halimbawa, you have a housing loan, you're paying 10,000 per month. You have a car loan, you're paying 10,000 per month. You have an appliance loan, 5,000 per month. Credit cards, you're paying 5,000 per month, and then you have a personal debt, 5,000 per month. So, ang total na utang mo is 35,000. Diba? Tapos, meron ka pang total expenses na 30,000. Ito yung mga basic needs mo. Kaya lang, ang total income mo, 60,000 lang. So, negative 5,000 ka pa. So, tingin mo makapag-ikot ka? Hindi, right? Kasi, in paying off your debt pa lang, and then in paying off your total expense pa lang, kulang na yung income na kinikita natin. So, according to this strategy, once you pay off one existing loan or one existing debt, huwag natin siya idagdag dun sa expenses allowance natin. Idagdag natin siya dun sa susunod na target natin na loan. So, say for example, in this event, natapos mo na yung personal debt mo na 5,000, ang gagawin mo is, idagdag mo yung 5,000 na yun dun sa budget mo sa pagbabayad ng credit card. Diba? So, kung nakita nyo dun sa second month, zero out na yung personal debt. So, ang budget mo na in paying off your loan is, your credit card is 10,000. So, on and so forth. Dire-diretso lang siya. So, pag natapos mo rin sa credit card, so yung budget mo na 15,000 or yung 10,000, idagdag mo dun sa budget mo for the appliance loan. Diba? So, instead of paying 5,000 only dun sa appliance loan natin, so 15,000 na yung budget natin, mas mabilis natin siyang nababayaran. After natin mabayaran yung appliance loan, dagdag natin yung budget dun sa car loan. So instead of paying 10,000, 25,000 na yung hinuhulog natin, mas mabilis natin siyang natatapos. So on and so forth. So if you notice, yung cash flow natin, mas lumalaki. So by doing this strategy, lumalaki yung cash flow natin, and then eventually from negative 5,000, nagkakaroon na tayo ng budget for investment or probably creating your emergency fund. Diba? So, ang pinapakita lang dito sa strategy na to is, every time you pay off a debt, huwag mo na siyang idagdag agad dun sa budget mo for expense. Dagdag mo siya agad dun sa budget mo to pay off or to target finishing off the next, yung next na utang. Diba? Para mas mabilis nating mabayaran, ma-zero out lahat. And then after that, mas lumalaki yung budget natin for investment and savings. So swap higher interest debt to lower interest. So say for example, may pinapakitang tatlong sample ng interest dito. Mayroong 60%, 30%, and then 10%. Kung halimbawa ang existing mo na loan is 10,000, na binibigyan ka ng 60% na interest rate per year. So that's 60,000 per year. Ang sabi, swap higher interest debt to lower interest. So why not find a loan that will give you only 10%, say for example, interest rate. Mas mababa, di ba, sa 60%. So kunin natin yung 10% na 100,000, that's only 10,000. So you get to save how much? 50,000, right? So ganito siya. Yung balance mo is you're paying 100,000, di ba? Yung minus 100,000 rather, yung minus 50,000, so meron pang remaining na 50,000. Dahil mababa na yung interest, hindi na yung 60,000 yung basis natin, right? Ang basis na natin is 10% interest rate. So what's 10% of 50,000? That's only 5,000. So savings mo is 60,000 minus mo yung 5,000 that you still need to pay to the interest of that 50,000 remaining loan. So you have 55,000. Balance is 50,000 minus yung 50,000 that you na savings mo. So you're already positive 5,000. So basically, para hindi confusing is, one very good strategy kung medyo mataas yung interest rate ng utang mo is find a loan with the lower interest rate, bayaran in full yung utang na mataas ang interest rate so that mas mababa yung interest rate nung existing na babayaran mo na lang ng utang. So what habit do you have? Sabi, getting into heavy debt usually happen over a long period of time. It's not overnight. Yung paunti-unti mong pagbili ng mga unnecessary items, di ba? Paunti-unti lang yan sa umpisa, pero nagpa-pile up na. And then, yung paunti-unti mong pag-acquire, say for example, na gaya kanina, nag-umpisa sa, yung sample kanina, di ba? Nag-umpisa sa housing loan, bumili na siya ng appliances, and then nag-start ng car loan, so paunti-unti, until nag-pile up. So it takes time, a habit of doing the same thing over and over again. So getting into heavy debt takes time also to eliminate it. So tiyagain lang ibig sabihin. So what habit do you have? Do you have the habit of saving or borrowing money? Do you have the habit of increasing income or increasing your expenses? Diba? Sa tingin nyo, alin dito sa dalawang habit na to ang magbibigay sa'yo ng solusyon to pay off your debt, to get out of debt, and to give you wealth? Is it saving or borrowing? Is it increasing your income or increasing your expenses? The answer is very obvious. So do all possible means to increase your cash flow. After work, find something that will give you additional income. You know that with your IMG membership, there is a benefit that will give you additional income during your spare time. Diba? Kung hindi mo pa napanood yung ating business training, we have the Jumpstart School. Nandito rin po yan sa ating tutorial hub. So just look for the training and the video for the entrepreneurship. Doon po i-discuss fully how you can increase your cash flow or earn additional income during your spare time to your IMG membership. And also another strategy, like what I mentioned earlier, to increase your cash flow is to minimize your expense. Because regardless kung gaano kalaki po ang ating income, kung mas malaki or equally same amount lang din ang ating expenses, so wala tayong cash flow. Diba? Find all possible means to reduce your expenses. Check diligently where you could cut costs. So the day you pay off your debt is the day you acquire your life, your freedom. Napakahirap po nang may utang na iniisip. Mahirap matulog minsan even yung pagkain is affected. So i-goal po nating lahat to live a life na walang utang. Napakasaya po niyan. You will really experience a life of freedom. na wala po tayong pinagkakautangan na kahit sinong tao. You can face anyone and definitely you will gain confidence to talk to anyone because you are debt-free. So another way to avoid debt is to build an emergency fund, diba? So don't just plan for the expected, plan also for the unexpected. Para magkaroon man ng emergency, borrowing money will not be an option for you. Meron kang paghuhugutan para dun sa emergency cases natin. So balikan lang natin, no? Build a solid financial foundation. Yun po ang target nating lahat dito sa IMG. That is why iniisa-isa natin ang financial concept. So we have already a video about protection, healthcare fund, life insurance. This video is specifically tackles about eliminating your debt. If you're going to apply all the concept that I just explained to you, definitely a day will come, you will become debt-free, create emergency fund, and then invest. So build a solid financial foundation. So anytime we go into debt, we lose some of our freedom. Ayaw natin yan. That is even in the Bible. According to Proverbs 22:7, the borrower is servant to the debtor. Minsan kapag may pinagkautangan tayo, hindi talaga natin kontrolado, di ba? Whatever they demand, you have to give. Lalo na kung may interest yung utang. So might as well, mas maganda targetin natin to become debt-free. So that's the end of our debt management training. I am pretty sure you've learned a lot. But you know, regardless kung mag-ilan yung or gano'ng karami yung natutunan natin ngayon, kung medyo indebted tayo at hindi natin i-apply yun, it will not take effect. It will not make any change in our financial life. But kung pag-aaralan natin mabuti, i-apply natin, especially discipline, talagang these financial concepts will help you become debt-free. And that's what we want to happen. Diba? So I hope this video helped you and taught you many things that you can share also to your friends and to your relatives. So should, in the event that you have questions, clarifications, you want to learn more, feel free to send us a message or the person who shared to you this video or your sponsor para mas matulungan po namin kayo. So happy learning! Tuloy-tuloy lang po tayo sa pag-aaral about our finances.